Top 10 Games 2021. Welcome to Top Everything, where you get top 10 videos on any and everything. In the past 18 months, games have been much more than just a pastime. Just look at the crucial role they've played in keeping people entertained, sane, and connected over the last 18 months of intermittent lockdowns. The impact of COVID on game development itself was felt throughout 2020 as much of the world adapted to working from home. But 2021 has made up for it with a string of releases that have showcased the very best of the medium. So in this video, we will discuss about the top 10 games of 2021. But before starting the video, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to never miss out on any of our videos. Number 10, the Neo Collection. Of the entire, like Dark Souls, but subgenre of games, the Neo series has arguably fared the best. Rather than try to recreate the aesthetics of the inimitable Souls franchise, Neo keeps the difficult, demanding combat and nuanced character building, but transports the action to a fantasy version of medieval Japan. There, you take control of a samurai as you explore the gorgeous countryside and fight off both mundane and demonic foes. The Neo Collection gathers both Neo and its sequel, then ups the performance to take full advantage of the PS5. There's even a 120Hz mode, if your TV can support it. You may have played the games before, but they hold up remarkably well. Number 9. Scarlet Nexus. Scarlet Nexus is a JRPG with an excellent story, awesome combat, and excellent characters. You play as either Cassan Randall or Yuito Tsumurugi and experience a gripping, branching story that should keep you engaged for the whole playtime. Throughout the game, you'll have access to psychokinetic powers as well as other abilities from your teammates. Scarlet Nexus has a lot going on, and the plot thickens drastically after the first few hours. And if you haven't enjoyed JRPGs in the past, check out this one. It features a lot of the genre's hallmarks while being a lot more straightforward than others of its kind. Number 8. Final Fantasy VII Remake Intergrade. Final Fantasy VII Remake was one of the best games of 2020, so it's no surprise that its PS5 expansion should be similarly excellent. There are two parts to Final Fantasy VII Remake Intergrade, the PS5 specific enhancements and the Intermission DLC episode. From a technical perspective, Intergrade improves FF7R's graphics, frame rate, and load times. But it's in the Intermission episode where the upgrade really shines. Here you can take control of fan favorite party member Yuffie Kisaragi in a brand new chapters. Between Yuffie's unique battle style and the deep cut characters she encounters along the way, FF7R Intergrade is sure to please longtime series fans. Number 7. Chivalry 2. Playing Chivalry 2 is some of the most fun I've ever had in a multiplayer game. Shooters and battle royale games typically focus on winner takes all competition, but Chivalry 2 is so bonkers that even when I'm getting my head cleaved off by a knight wielding a monstrous axe, I'm still grinning away. There are leaderboards and kill and death ratios in Chivalry 2, but what makes this sequel to the 2012 Chivalry Medieval Warfare so delightful is that it prioritizes fun over everything else. Its brand of medieval carnage can be extremely brutal, and the game offers a surprising amount of tactical depth. But you'll spend more time laughing at your own demise than cursing your opponent for getting the drop on you. What other multiplayer game lets you beat your enemies to death with a chicken, or throw your teammate's decapitated head at a charging foe? Chivalry 2 is uncomplicated fun. Number 6. Nier Replicant. Nier Replicant is one of the strangest games of the year. If you're into that sort of thing, it's also one of the best. In this remaster of the 2010 cult classic action RPG, you take control of Nier, a young man who sets out on a quest to save his sister from a mysterious plague. Along the way, he teams up with a standoffish book, a skeletal sorcerer, and a foul-mouthed swordswoman, all of whom have some seriously odd interpersonal issues to work out. The action-packed gameplay works well enough, but it's the unusual cast of characters and melancholic story that make Nier Replicant worth checking out. Number 5. Resident Evil Village. Resident Evil Village became something of a meme, thanks to the instantly magnetic vampiress, Lady Dimitrescu. However, Lady D and her unusual daughters are only part of the reason why Resident Evil Village works so well. The game is also filled with intense combat in a large, detailed world to explore. Some moments from the game represent the scariest this series has been in years, or failing that, at least the goriest. Essentially, Resident Evil Village builds on the strengths of Resident Evil 7 while incorporating some beloved features from earlier games in the franchise. It's a satisfying adventure with lots of reasons to replay it once you're done. Number 4. Hitman 3. Hitman 3 is a welcome reminder of how skilled developer IO Interactive has become at building complex levels that run like clockwork. Players have so many compelling opportunities to slip in as the well-shaved assassin Agent 47 and throw a wrench into the gears. In addition to bringing the conspiracy-laden narrative of the world of assassination, Hitman Trilogy to a satisfying close, Hitman 3 delivers some of the best missions in the series. From the Bond-esque opening of the Dubai level to the murder mystery homage that is in the Dartmoor mission, each offers a masterclass in level design. The open-ended nature of the Berlin level is especially welcome, and it hints at where the next generation of Hitman games could go. Number 3. Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart is perhaps the best game on the PS5 so far, and with competition like Spider-Man, Miles Morales, and Demon's Souls, that's saying something. This action platformer finally picks up where Ratchet & Clank Into the Nexus left off way back in 2013, delivering a satisfying sci-fi story about dimension-hopping heroes and villains. The gameplay is top-notch, with a large arsenal of bizarre customizable weapons and 10 inventive secret-filled levels to explore. But what's really impressive about Rift Apart is how well it showcases the PS5's unique features, from its almost instantaneous loading times to its subtle DualSense feedback for every different weapon. Number 2. Mass Effect Legendary Edition. BioWare remastered the legendary Mass Effect trilogy for a new generation, welcoming old fans back with some visual and quality of life enhancements. But Mass Effect Legendary Edition is also the best way to play the games overall, making it perfect for people who have never played the trilogy before. Playing through Commander Shepard's journey is an amazing and emotional experience. The characters are why people love the space opera, but the setting and lore are also huge draws. Before revealing the number one game, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to Top 10 Everything. Number 1. Returnal. Returnal is the first game played on PS5 that felt genuinely next-gen. The combination of lightning-fast load times, remarkable artistic direction, and its still unmatched implementation of DualSense haptics created an experience that's almost entirely justified the console's sizable entry fee. Developer Housemarque has always been an underappreciated studio in my eyes, but Returnal solidified it, just how talented the team is. The game's punishing roguelike structure makes every encounter feel intense, and laser-sharp focus is at all times necessary. Returnal frequently requires you to make tough decisions when it comes to item management, creating an engaging risk-to-reward dynamic. Thank you guys for watching. If you want more videos like this one, make sure to like the video and hit the subscribe button, and we will see you in the next video.